Well, President Trump taking on a new task today, laying out his vision on how to boost business opportunities for women. The president meeting with female business owners earlier at the White House, where he said the administration is working on, among other things, making child care more affordable and accessible.
Empowering and promoting women in business is an absolute priority in the Trump administration because I know how crucial women are as job creators, role models, and leaders all throughout our communities.
Joining me now, one of the business leaders who met with President Trump today, Lili Gil Valletta, and, Jillian Melcher's here too. Lili, congratulations on the meeting.
Thank you very much.
All right, so walk us through, tell us how it all went.
So it was a very intimate and small room of barely 11 of us, women-owned business, business owners and leaders. And I was proud to be one of four Hispanic-owned businesses around the table to talk about the issues that we face and the barriers that we can collectively, work on together as women and as minorities who are driving the growth in new firms in this country and therefore making us the lead job creators as we look into the future and on the American prosperity overall.
Right. Let me ask, what's the distinction, though? If you're in a meeting like this and President Trump's met with a lot of different business leaders, what was so distinctive about your group as opposed to any group he might have already met with?
I think our unique journeys and the diversity around the table clearly is a portrait of America. As women, we face challenges. There are challenges that come with the responsibilities we have in the household. There are challenges in access to capital and networks and opportunity. And we have to address those unique challenges, especially since we are the ones that are driving the small business growth.
Right.
Therefore, the future of America depends on us achieving our full potential as small business owners so that we can have the full, force of job creation and revenues that this country needs to see.
Jillian, during the campaign, President Trump was inspired by Ivanka on a lot of things, including child care, which a lot of people think if you start to look at that and get some help there, the so-called wage gap will go away because, most economists say it's a factor of really a function of women leaving the workforce to raise kids.
Yeah, I mean, I think with this, the important thing to emphasize is that women should have that choice to be able to go home and to come back into the work world. We want policies that will accommodate that while also not creating a disincentive for women, making them more expensive than male employees. That's really important. But if we're looking at the broader economic picture here, I think Independent Women's Forum, which I'm part of, does a great job of driving home the point that all issues are women's issues, that if we want to improve opportunities for female business owners, you do that by removing regulation and creating pro-growth policies. And I think that's what we'll have to judge this effort on.
Do you have any problem with the government getting involved with perhaps a new entitlement? Once they start providing some sort of financial incentive for childcare, there's no turning back.
Yeah, I mean, I think there are a lot of ways that this can go wrong. I mean, it's important to women that they be able to do both of these things and do them well. I think part of the way that you do that, though, is by teaching women to negotiate, teaching them to handle it their own. I don't think in this case government necessarily makes the problem better.
Right. Of course, we've seen many studies where women just simply don't ask for a big raise, even when they're the best worker there and the men, we don't care how sloppy we are, we think we're entitled. So Lili, tell us about the future now. You've had this meeting, you also met with Ivanka Trump too. So you're really starting to understand this White House. Are you confident now that there will be certain policies coming that will spur on growth, not just for women, but for small businesses in general?
I think the message was clear today that this is the beginning of a journey. It's a marathon, not a sprint, for us to really move forward with policies that impact and make a difference that to remove some of these barriers for small businesses. You have heard about deregulation already. We talked about it. There is tax reform. There is access to capital. There is also improving the training of a highly skilled workforce, which begins with a lot of us moms of young children, boys and girls that need to see a future in STEM and careers in technology that really are what we need to be a winning economy in the global place.
All right.
So that's all of the things that were discussed. Ivanka clearly is playing an active role in all things women empowerment, so I wouldn't be surprised if there are councils or working sessions that follow up. The president and vice president were clear in their support of women and small businesses. Also, the administrator of the Small Business Administration, Administrator Mike McMahon, was in the room. So now we are looking forward to holding each other accountable. So this
the SBA starts giving out loans to small businesses because before now, you really could only get a loan if you didn't really need a loan. Congratulations, Lili. Thanks a lot, Jillian. Ladies, we got to leave it there. Coming up.